Hello once again and welcome to the Amalgamated with Christ Church, where the purpose of it remains the same: to bring people back into fellowship with God through Jesus Christ. And so this morning, let's look at the book of Ezekiel. Ezekiel chapter 37, 1 to 14. Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 to 14. Again, it's one of those sermons that was received before I was called into pastoring. But I am the firm believer that whenever the Holy Spirit gives you a word, you are to write it down. Sometimes it makes no sense to you when you receive it, but you're to write it down, because God's word will always find a place. God's word, once it goes forth, it must accomplish a task. It doesn't matter how long ago, when it's going to do what it says. Now, Ezekiel 37, 1 to 14, that particular portion of scripture is about the valley of dry bones. It's a prophetic portion of scripture, and here it emphasizes, or it is emphasizing, the sovereign power of God. This prophecy was intended for the children of Israel at that time. But we will also look at how it is relevant to us today. You see, back then they were demoralized. Back then there was turmoil. Back then they were experiencing attacks by foreign forces. One of the key perpetrators at that time was the Assyrian, and they also had the assistance of the Egyptian army. Then came a time when they were enslaved in Babylon, so it was pure turmoil. So we want to put ourselves, or to interject ourselves, into such a situation today. Because today we have turmoil. Today many of us are demoralized. Today many of us are suffering varying attacks, spiritual attacks, physical attacks, mental attacks. Everything is just coming and coming and coming, and it appears as if there is no end in sight. It was the same thing back then. There were experiencing turmoil. But God used this particular man, this prophet Ezekiel. Let me tell you something. He was not spared from the turmoil, because he was also caught up. He was caught up in the midst of it. And he identified himself as someone that was experiencing hardship. There was no special privilege for him, because he made it clear in chapter 1, verses 1. It says right here, "Now it came to pass in the 30th year, in the fourth month of the fifth day of the month, as I was among the captive," Many times people like to look at preachers or look at certain people who God used to deliver a word and say, "You're only talking, but you do not know what I'm going through." And I'm saying to you, that's a wrong concept. Because here we saw even Ezekiel himself telling you that he was among the captive. When you're in captivity, you do not have the luxury of certain freedom. When you're in captivity, you're no longer free to do as you want to do. When you're in captivity, most of the time, someone is going to tell you what to do, when to do, and how to do. When you're in captivity, most time all hopes is gone. And so there is a reason for one to be demoralized. There is a reason for one to be in distress. But there is also a reason at that time to listen for the voice of God. Because when you least expect it, that's when God is going to come forth. And that's when you're going to receive a word. That's when you're going to receive instruction. Nevertheless, there is turmoil. But at the same time, if you're not caught up in all the activities and not sitting down feeling sorry for yourself, then you will hear from God. And so Ezekiel himself, he was caught up in it. He detailed his time in exile. And though he was in exile, he never gave up hope. And that's a lesson for many of us today. You may be caught up in turmoil. You may be faced with certain situation, but do not give up hope. Though he was in turmoil, he did not lose or he did not lose focus. He did not forsake a relationship with God. Many of us today, as soon as there's a little shaking, as soon as there's a little thing that rock our boat, we lose fellowship. We fall out of fellowship with God. We cannot no longer wait on God. And here we see something that's totally different. He kept fellowship with God. Though it's enough to say that you're going through a situation, I'm saying to you once again, you should not give up. Because the scripture reminds you that though you may endure hardship, though you may be going through something that is unpleasant, the scripture makes it clear and it tells you that though you may have a little bit of weeping, though you may have a little bit of mourning, but such a thing that's called joy will come. But if you fail to realize a relationship with God, you will never experience the promise of joy that's going to come. It's going to dawn when you least expect it. It says right here in the Psalm 30 and 5, for his anger is but for a moment, his favor is for life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Once you give up hope, my brothers and sisters, you will never experience the thing that is called joy. It is going to come, and it comes from God. It is not by chance. This is not something that you can purchase. This is not something that society can give you. Society can throw happiness at you. And so many of us are caught up and believe that we are supposed to be happy every day. But let me tell you something. Happiness is just a state. It's a state. It may be brief. It may be fleeting. Euphoria. That's what many of us call happiness. And so we search for happiness in various places. We search for happiness in the bottles. We search for happiness in substance. We search for happiness in illicit lifestyle. Things that has nothing to do with God. Because we fail to maintain a relationship with God. But once again, because Ezekiel maintain a relationship with God, he was called out, he was favored, he was given an assignment. Though he was in captivity, he never lost sight of who his creator was. Because let me say this to you, he said right there in chapter 1 that he was among the captive. He was among the captive. He was suffering. But he maintained a relationship with God. And because he maintained a relationship with God, he was worthy of the assignment that he was going to be given. So you must maintain a relationship with God to realize your assignment, because in chapter 2, and look at this, and verse 3, and he said to me, Son of man, I am sending you to the children of Israel. Now he was called out to be a prophet right then and there. He was given an assignment because of his relationship. He says, Son of man, I am sending you to the Israelites, a rebellious nation. A prophet is called by God, and he is instructed by God, not by his own imagination. When the prophet is called by God, it's usually to go forth and give warning and prophecy, which is the message. A prophet do not give fables as we see today. A prophet must spark repentance by the very words that God give him. But what do we see happening today? We see prophets sparking and pushing people further and further away from God. You know the reason for that? Because they were never given an assignment by God. When a prophet is sent by God, or was sent by God as back then, they came to do one thing. To ignite, to make sure the people realize that they're in error, and start something which is repentance. In the book of Zechariah chapter 1 verse 6, it said, Yet surely my words and my statutes, which I command my servants the prophets, they did not overtake your fathers, so they returned, meaning they repented. But what do we see happening today? When the prophets today come, people do not want to repent. People look to these prophets to tell them how to be rich, to tell them how to get it. And so guess what? Many of us are languishing in the valley of dry bones because we have no relationship with God, and we're not hearing for any prophet that comes from God. The first thing about this portion of scripture that we're looking at in the book of Ezekiel, I want you to understand that the name is significant. The name is significant. Ezekiel means God is strong, or God strengthens. For God to strengthen you, you must have a relationship with him. You can't go around and singing, you are my strength, but at the same time, you have no relationship with God. You can't go around and talking about your experience in the favor of God when you have no relationship with him. It's totally contrary for you to utter such words. Isaiah 41, fear not, I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. So when you have a relationship with God, he strengthens you. When you have a relationship with God through Jesus Christ, it does not matter the circumstances, does not matter what valley you are in. And so it brings us full circle to the prophet, what he has to say, Ezekiel 37, the valley of dry bones. Does not matter what exile situation you're in, what sort of turmoil you're going through, does not matter. Because you must understand scripture. For all things work together for those of us who love him, who are called according to his purpose. But I want you to understand that at the beginning of that verse, it says, and we know. So if you do not have a relationship with him, you will never know. You'll never experience. And so you're going to keep languishing in the valley of dry bones. Now, a particular phrase occur in the portion of scripture in the book of Ezekiel. It says, the hand of the Lord is upon me. The hand of the Lord, this particular phrase occurs approximately 7 times in the book of Ezekiel. And it literally indicates an overpowering experience of divine revelation. When the hand of God is upon you, it indicates an overpowering experience of divine revelation. This is not something that is coming from social media. This is not something that's coming from your favorite pastor. This is because God himself has laid a hand on you. And so when God has laid a hand on you, it does not matter what valley you are in, because you have an overpowering experience of divine revelation. For you to have such an experience, you must have a relationship with Christ. Without Jesus, there is no divine revelation. All you're receiving is earthly or demonic revelation. And so you will keep suffering. You will keep languishing in this said valley of dry bones. And so let's look at this very carefully. The hand of God, 37 verse 1, the hand of the Lord came upon me. So it's safe to say that for someone to operate in the divine, the hand of God must be upon them. You cannot get up today and decide that you're going to do this and you're going to do that, and the hand of God is not on you. All you're doing is faking it to make it, but you will not make it in the kingdom of God. And then the portion of scripture talk about again dry bones. Right here in Ezekiel 37. And it says, the hand of the Lord came upon me and brought me out in the spirit of the Lord and sat me in the midst of the valley, and it was full of bones. The valley of dry bones. It stood for hopelessness of Israel. And so today, many of us are in the valley of dry bones, which is very, very synonymous with them back then. We are in a hopeless situation. We're in exile. Dry bones must be interpreted as hopeless situation, a situation in which one is experiencing dire circumstances, problems and tribulations. Everything is coming upon you. Everything that will deprive you of hope. What is depriving you of hope today? Is it family life? Is it in school? Is it health? Is it violence within your community? What is it that is depriving you of hope? Are you in a valley of dry bones today? If yes, you better take heed. You better listen very carefully, because you will never get out of the valley of dry bones unless there is a relationship with God. God can give life to dry bones. God give hope to the hopeless. Again, Ezekiel 37 verse 1, let's look at how it began. You see where Ezekiel says right here, look. Oh Lord, you know. Oh Lord, you know. I mean, look at verse 3, because he come on down, verse 2. Then he caused me to pass by them all around, and behold, there were many in the open valley. And indeed, there were very dry, many bones. Hopeless situation, countless situation. And God said to him, son of man, can these bones live? And he said right there, Lord, you know. Meaning God knows the outcome of your problems before you do. God, you know. You're going through a situation, but do not take it for granted. God knows the outcome before you do. But in order for you to experience the favor, in order for you to be elevated, in order for you to be rescued, there must be a situation in which God can communicate with you. Because if you are too caught up in the hopelessness around you, you'll never see what God is showing you. And so instead of you seeing a way out and saying, God, you know, what will you be doing? All you will be doing is wallowing in self-pity, crying and thinking about how life is so unfair. Life is not fair. Yeah, life is not fair. It's not fair. It's not fair for those of us who are without Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. Because when you are with him, you understand for all that, and we know that all things work together for good. But if you're not with him, you do not understand that though you're going through a situation, some goodness is going to come out of you. Say, preacher, what good can come out of that situation? We will see based on the valley of dry bones. The scripture says, very many, very many. Look at verse 2. It says, There were very many in the open valley. Very many symbolizing a whole community in exile. Today it is the same. Great many people are exiled to sin. Very many. Some people that we know. Some people that we cherish. Some people that we love. Some people that we look to. They are exiled to a situation of sin. Very many. People are dry and dead to sin, and there is no hope for them because they are caught up in this society, which is nothing but a valley of dry bones. Can we see the parallel today? Can we see the parallel within our society today? There is hopelessness all around. People are using synthetic substances to try to get ahead. Some people cannot function unless they take a little drink, cannot function unless they take a little hopper, cannot function unless they do something illicit, cannot function because they are weak, because they are stranded and dried out in the valley of dry bones. But I say to you today, do not allow the situation that is happening today to dictate your future, because God knows the outcome. You hear of wars today. You see war. People bracing themselves for nuclear war. People bracing themselves because of disasters. People bracing themselves because of political violence. People bracing themselves. And everything seems so hopeless. Every day you have to do something differently. When you think that your money is safe in the bank, the thieves go in and they drain your account. Drain your life savings. And so we have to be armed with passwords. You have to have a password to unlock the password that you put in. And then you still have to have a backup password. And ever so often, you have to change your password. And your password can never be repeated. That's the society we're living in today. The valley of dry bones. The valley of dry bones. God knows the outcome. Ezekiel said, God, you know. For you know. So I answered, oh Lord, you know. If you do not have a relationship with God, you will never know that God knows. He's all knowing. But many of us today pretend like we know instead of giving it over to God. We pretend that we know and we want to fix our dry situation. And so many times we want to do something artificial. We want to do something to create a little moisture. We want to create something to put a little life into situation. Not knowing that when you are trying to fix things, all you're doing is creating a mess. Because you cannot create life. God is the only one. When you have a relationship with God, when you have a relationship with God, you will have the ability to do certain things that the natural man will not be able to do. You will have the ability to prophesy over to yourself, to prophesy over your dry bones. So speak life into your situation, life into your hopeless situation. Instead of you sitting down and wallowing and bawling and wondering who is going to help you to get out of this, you speak to God. You speak to your situation in the name of Jesus. Be moved. Many of us have no faith because we are stuck in the valley of dry bone. Jesus said, if your faith was as small as a mustard seed, you'll be able to say to this mountain, move, and this mountain will move. But some of us have no fortitude, no spiritual gutso to move things that's within our life. You want to move mountains, but you cannot even open doors. You can't, because you're spiritually weak. You have no strength. You don't want to spend time in the things of God. And that's the reason the valley of dry bones is so vast. That's the reason the prophet says there are many, 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 many around us. dry bones around us. But it's time for you to realize who you are in Christ. It's time for you to realize that you're more than conquerors. It's time for you to realize that you can speak to your dry bones. And when you speak to your dry bones, you will hear a little crackling. You hear a little rattling, because the Lord thy God is with you. Fear not, for I, the Lord, your God is with you. When you have no experience in certain matters, do not worry. Do not worry, because God is leading you, not you leading yourself. Not you leading yourself. Dry bones. Dry bones. God give you authority to speak. Just like God says right here to the prophet Ezekiel in verse 4. Again, he said to me, prophesy to these bones and say to them, oh, dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Ezekiel did not take it unto himself to say, hear my words. Many of us are trying to fix things by saying, oh, I am speaking to you. No, you are not. God is speaking through you. And it's the word of the Lord that's going to move the mountains, not your experience in the matter. If you were so good, it would not keep occurring. But because you're just a man, understand you're limited and you need God. You need Christ. You need the Holy Spirit to dictate to you. You need the Holy Spirit. You need God to order your steps. Dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Dry bones, hear what the sovereign Lord have to say. Thus said the Lord God to these bones, surely I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. And you shall live. I will put sinews on you and bring flesh upon you, cover you with skin and put breath in you, and you shall live. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. We have a problem today. We have a problem today. We have a problem today. Many of us do not want to use the word of God to speak to our situation. Many of us do not want to use the word of God, so we try to do things on our own. We want to use the words of divinators and magicians. We want to use gambling. We want to use scamming. We want to use everything that is not of God. And guess what? All you're doing is creating a mess for yourself. Look at verse 6 once again, my brothers and sisters. He says, I will put sinews on you, so you do as you're told by God. When you're going through the valley of dry bones, all you need to do is praise. All you need to do is travail. All you need to do is to continue to press on. Deliverance will come. When you least expect it, deliverance will come. God restores. God rebuilds. God makes perfect sense of what is nonsense to man. Dry bones in action. But when God speaks, when God decides to act, it comes in stages. The problem is many of us do not want to start, but we want to finish. Many of us don't want to go through the situation, not knowing that sometimes there's going to be a little high, there's going to be a little low, there's going to be a little lull, there's going to be a little slowing down, there's going to be a little speeding up. But most of us want it to be done now, because we can't wait. We attempt to fix things on ourselves. But look at the order in which God do things. Speak. Prophesy to these bones. God did not just come and put sinews. God said to the man of God, prophesy to these bones. There's an order in which God do things. You must understand that there is an order in the kingdom of God. You can't just go out and just decide that this is going to happen. No. There is order. God is a God of order. Don't get out of order with your character. Don't think you're going to trick God into action. God restores, God make perfect, but it comes in stages. Note, there was just a dry bone languishing, and God had to appoint a man to come and speak to these dry bones. But before God even said to the man, speak, God said to the man, look, do you see all that? There are many, many dry bones. So the man of God must first observe, because he's been led by God. Don't just rush into a situation. Even you who are going through, don't just rush into a situation and decide to do. sit back and allow God to show you and tell you what to do. Because that's exactly what happened here. God said, do you see all of that? Then God said, prophesy. And then when he prophesied, what did God do? God said, I will put sinews. Many of us want the flesh to appear, but we don't want the sinews. Knowing that the sinews is tough and fibrous, and the sinews, all the bones together. You see, you must go back to your biology, go back to your anatomy and physiology class. Then you will clear, you will understand, you will have a clearer understanding of how things work. There is order. Bones without sinews is worthless. All it will do is just flap around. Sinews, stuff, and fibrous to hold the bones in place. God did not just say, I'm going to allow flesh to come over these bones. It will just be flesh and bone. But the sinews, because there must be order. There must be order. So God said right here, I will put sinews on you and bring flesh upon you. When the sinews come upon you and then the flesh come upon you, the flesh with the veins and all of that will carry the nutrients throughout. But then you cannot be left naked. So God says what? I will cover you with skin, but you're still dead. If you run ahead and think because you have a little sinew, because you have some flesh, because you have some skin, you can do as you want. No, you still have to wait for God to finish the work. And so God said right here, I will put breath in you and you shall live. Amen. Dry bones in action. Sinews. Without sinews, bones fall apart. Sinews need to be in place so I can do this with my arm. I can do this. I can do all of that with my arm. There was no sinews. It will just be a big flap. That's all it would be. That's all it would be. But the sinews hold the bones in place. There's a spiritual rebuilding that is needed in our society. There is a process that is missing. We want skin to cover our nastiness. We want skin to cover our slackness. But you should go back to the rebuilding stage, because many of us are still languishing in sin. We're in the valley of dry bones. But God will restore. But it takes time. There is an order in which God do things. You're still dead no matter how good you look. You may have some sinews. You may have some flesh. You may have some skin. But you abort the situation. When the breath of life was going to go in you, you abort it. All you saw was a little glimpse, a little glimmer. And you run ahead, you decide to do things on your own strength. And so the breath of God is not in you. It's not in you. No wonder many of us, we start out great and then we walk down the road, we fall down. God give you a glimpse of what is to happen, of what is to come. But you run ahead of a situation. You can't wait for God. And so once you're back in the valley of dry bones. You're languishing in the valley of dry bones. You were making it out. But you can't wait. You can't wait. And so now you're back where you began. God, the breath of life. The breath of life. But you see, there it comes with obedience. Because God showed him all these things. And so in verse 7 he says, so I prophesied as I was commanded. I prophesied. You see, God said to him, again he said, prophesy to these bones. Thus said the Lord, surely I will cause breath to enter into you. I will put sinews. God is showing you what is to come. I will. But you must do something. You must be obedient. Verse 7, it says, so I prophesy as I was commanded. And as I prophesied, there was a noise, a sudden rattling, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Indeed, as I looked, the sinews appeared. The flesh came upon them, and the skin covered them. But there was no breath in them. There was no breath in them. Also, he said to me, prophesy to the bread, prophesy, son of man, and said to the bread, thus said the Lord come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe on these slain, and they may live. Many of us want to abort the situation, and so there is no dry bone in action. All you have is dry bone laying exposed to the sun. We are weak and anemic Christians because we fail to obey the word of God. Now remember this, remember this. Ezekiel prophesied, he was commanded. And as he was prophesying, there was a noise, a rattling sound. The bones come together, bone to bone. When we obey, God moves. But you cannot want God to move and you're not obedient to him. You cannot be obedient to social media, but not to God. You cannot have joy doing the things of the world, but no joy doing the things of God. No wonder many of us, though we're in Christendom and we're in some mega churches, we are still weak and anemic. Because all there is just a big auditorium full of dry bones. Full of dry bones. There's no rattling there. There's no movement there. There's no sinews connecting, nothing. There's no flesh, there's no skin, there's no breath. All you have is just dry bones looking there. Dry bones looking there. Now, let me say this to you once more. Remember, the dry bones represent hopelessness, hopelessness, hopelessness. We're inundated with hopelessness today. But when you walk with God, you hear the noise of your bone. When you walk with God, you hear the rattling sound of bones. It may be dry, meaning it may be hard. It may be dusty, meaning it may be tough. It may be buried, meaning people give up on you. But listen to this, listen to this. Hear the word of the Lord God. But God can cause a shifting. God can cause a rattling. God can cause the dry bones to be in action. So no matter what you're going through, your job is to remain rooted. Your job is to remain planted. Your job is to listen for the word of God. Your job is to obey when God said to move. Your job is not to say, oh God, you're saying it, but I'm not moving right now. I'm waiting for you because I'm just getting a promotion right here. No, move, because God is saying you are to move. When you're about to receive godly intervention, meaning when you're going to hear the dry bones rattling, press on, keep praying. You may hear a little rattling, but that's just the beginning. You may hear a whole bunch of noise, but don't give up yet. Keep pressing, keep pressing. You're still waiting for the sinews to come to attach the bones together. Keep pressing, keep pressing. Even when you see the sinews appear, you still need the flesh. Keep pressing, keep pressing. Even when the flesh appear, you still need the skin. Keep pressing, keep pressing. Even when you get the skin, you still need the breath of life within you. What you need to do when you're going through the valley of dry bones, going through your hopeless situation, is keep prophesying to your situation in the name of Jesus. When you want to see sinews added, you go harder in prayer. You open your eyes and you see your skeleton standing up. You do not give up and say, this is it. No, you pray some more. You want some flesh to appear. When you see the flesh appear, you don't give up. You need to pray some more. When you see the skin appear, you don't give up. You need to pray some more. When you see the breath of life and you start to move in, you do not give up. You want to have endurance in the name of Jesus. But many of us remain hopeless in our situation. We have no prayer life. We don't have any fellowship. We don't go to church. We don't go to Bible studies. We have all the time in the world. We enjoy ourselves. We like to sleep late. We like to do all the trappings of society and never give up a word to God. And then we wonder when we're going through. That's the reason many of us in Christendom and many of us in society like to ask this foolish question, where is God when things are hard? Where is God? He was speaking to you in the valley of dry bones, but you didn't want to hear him. He was speaking to you when you believe you made it, when you have a little sinew, but you didn't want to hear him. He was speaking to you when a little flesh occurred, but you didn't want to hear him because you got some money now. He was speaking to you when you have some skin over you, but you didn't want to hear him because you got a big house now. He was speaking with you when he just go Well, he didn't want to hear you think you made it, you can do all by yourself. Knowing that just a little.
That's right.
You have to wait on God to get the full. But you don't want to wait. And so you keep being stuck in the valley of dry bones. You want to see victory? Keep pressing on. The enemy wants you to think about your dry bones, meaning you to think about your hopeless situation, to think about your illness, to think about your financial situation, to think about how people are hating you. And that's what society is full of today. Oh, they're hating me. They're hating me. Everywhere you walk, someone, oh, it's full of haters. The world has already been full of haters from the get-go. There's nothing new. All you need to do is overcome the haters. Overcome the haters through prayer and supplication. Stop worrying about the haters. Let the haters be the one that wake up in the middle of the night thinking, oh, I wonder what he's doing over there. You don't worry about the haters. Why are you going to bed when you should be sleeping, but you're wondering what someone else is thinking about you? That's not your job to wonder what someone else is thinking about you. Your job is to sleep. Your job is to rest in the arm of Jesus. Cast all your burdens on him, but you don't want it. You want to carry a big burden, and every time you go somewhere, you drop your bag of dry bones. You drop your bag of hopelessness. You're getting a way out, you drop your bag of hopelessness. Society want to see you buried. They don't want to see your dry bones in action. They don't want to see your dry bones dancing, mean rejoicing. Society wants you to bury your hopelessness in the lotto. Society wants you to bury your hopelessness in scamming. Bury your hopelessness in excessive alcohol consumption. Bury your hopelessness in illicit sex. Bury your hopelessness in trashy music. Bury your hopelessness in Hollywood fairy tales. That's what society wants you to do. Bury your hopelessness in gossip. Bury your hopelessness in some little church that giving you a little patting on the head. That's what society wants you to do. But that will never heal your dry bones. You think this life is a cartoon story or a Cinderella story? There's no happily ever after right here. There's no happily ever after. Look at how many of us try to achieve things, to achieve the happily ever after. How many people you know go involved with sorcery because they want a happily ever after, and look at their hand. How many people you know to invest in some illicit activity, and look at their hand. Look at their hand. There's no happily ever after in things of the world. None of that is going to make sense to you. Dry bones in action, my brothers and sisters. Blessed is the one who does not walk in step with the wicked. The King James Version, that's Psalm 1 verse 1. Blessed is the man. You see, the world cannot give you godly counsel. The world cannot give you godly counsel, but many of us are walking in step with the world, not understanding that it's a vast world of dry bone out there. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and to approve what God will is for you. It's good and pleasing and perfect will. But you cannot understand that or appreciate that if you're stuck in the valley of dry bones. It's time for you to start living as a child of God. You're saying, preacher, it is hard. I keep having all these misfortune upon misfortune, misfortune. The scripture says, don't think it strange about this fiery trials that's about to try you as though some strange thing has happened to you. Oh, preacher, let's look at what is happening to my life. I don't have it easy. If anyone suffers for being a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but glorify God in this matter. When you understand those verses, I'm not saying suffering is a pleasant thing. I'm not saying when you're going through pain, you can't cry. I'm not saying you have to jump up like you're some crazy person. Woohoo! Thank God for pain. No. No, you're not going to do that. But at the same time, you're going to glorify God, because at least you can feel pain. I've seen many people laying in bed. They have no feeling. Their legs are falling off and they can't tell. Maggot infestation and they can't tell. At least you are feeling. Some people will pay anything in the world to feel a little bit of pain. You take things for granted. You have to understand what the world is. You have to understand that the world, the root word is cosmos, which means ungodly multitude. The mass of men are alienated from God in this ungodly multitude, and they're hostile towards the things of Christ. And that's why Romans chapter 1 tell you that the wrath of God has been revealed against, it's been revealed from heaven. So therefore, do not conform to the pattern of this world. From cosmos, you get cosmetic, meaning everything is made to look beautiful, is made to lure you in. But all you're being lured into is a great valley of dry bones. And once they pull the shell over you, you'll be dried out. You'll be dried out. So when they pull you out and tell you that you're going to enjoy yourself and you follow them, you're going to be dried out, sucking the breath of life out of you, because the word of God has been smothered by the nastiness of society. And when the word of God has been sucked out of you because it's been smothered by corruption, then guess what is coming next? Your skin will be ripped off of you. Then your flesh will be gone. Then your sinews will be gone. And all you'll be is just a bunch of dry bones laying down there languishing. One dry bone up on top of dry bone. Dry bones are your situation today. Your problems, God can breathe new life into them. Nothing is impossible for God except lying. Nothing is impossible. So don't get it twisted, my brothers and sisters. People say nothing is impossible for God. And I say, yes, something is impossible for God. God can't lie. God cannot lie. So you understand that God cannot lie. It says in Hebrews chapter 6, verse 18, that by two immutable things, meaning unchanging, in which it is impossible for God to lie. So God can't lie. So everything is impossible except God cannot lie. So God can speak into any situation, but society will want to make up a lie and tell you that God is the one that say it is so. But if you understand the word of God, you'll understand that God cannot lie. They will say, it's okay for you to do this because God said you should not suffer. God said the wealth of the wicked is stored up for the righteous. And so you go out there hunting the wealth of the wicked, when the scripture clearly said to seek ye first. God cannot lie. God cannot lie. No matter how they pretty it up or they cherry pick it, God cannot lie. God cannot lie. God cannot lie. God won't show up. God won't show up if you don't want him to. The problem is many of us are in a situation. Many of us are in a situation, but we still don't want God to show up and to move us out of it. Because we want God to show up when we are ready for him to show up. That's the problem. We want God to move when we want him to move. God won't show up. God won't show up. And so many of us are ignorant to the things of God. May I remind you, my brothers and sisters, that all that you believe you're going through, all the suffering that Christ suffered as well, may I remind you, you're saying, but oh, Satan keeps showing up and tempting me. Do you remember Satan show up and tempt Jesus Christ, the man here? And Jesus Christ, the man full of the wisdom of God, says, away from me, away from me. But guess what? Many of us can't say away from me. We embrace the deceit of Satan because we don't know the word of God, because we are in the valley of dry bones. Sometimes the situation that you're faced with may be familiar to you. Dry bones may be just in your house. It may be in your church. It may be in your school. It may be on your job. Dry bones may come in the form of people that you know and you trust. Situation may occur and God is showing you a way out. And as soon as God is going to show you a way out, dry bones start rattling, but it's the wrong bone. This bone don't come from God. And I tell you that it happens to the best of us. And sometimes these dry boners believe that they're doing the work of God. Even when Jesus Christ was about to go to the cross, Peter was saying to him, Matthew 16, verse 22, then Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. Can you imagine Peter rebuking Christ? Because, shut up, why are you saying that? Yeah, listen, Peter rebuking Christ. Far be it from you, Lord. This shall not happen to you. But Jesus Christ, turned around and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. Sometimes people around you think they're doing things to benefit you. But you must understand the work of the enemy. We do not fight against flesh and blood. Jesus did not say, Peter, get away. Rebuke the spirit that was in him. And that's dry bones can come camouflage. Dry bones can come camouflage. Because sometimes they mean you well, but the enemy will sneak in a little thing. When God give you an assignment, do not be distracted. Stick to it. Do not be distracted. Stick to it. Prophet Ezekiel, verse 9, chapter 37, also it said to me, prophesy to the bread. Prophesy, son of man, and say to the bread, thus say to the Lord, come. See? So as I prophesied, he commanded me, the bread came into them, and they lived and stood upon their feet, and an exceedingly great army. Prophesy bread into the dry bone. God promises restoration to the scattered and to the hopeless. The breath of God is the spirit of God. The spirit of God brings restoration. It brings joy. It brings security. It brings everything that you're looking for. But there must be some allegiance to God. Total, 100%. Dry bones in action. Dry bones in action. Look at 37 and verse 11. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They indeed say, our bones are dry, our hope is lost. Today the world may be looking at you. You may be cut off. The world may be laughing. But now God can make your dry bones dancing. Look who's laughing now. Look who's laughing now. They say you can't do it. They say you're crazy, just like they were saying to Noah. In the days of Noah, man were marrying, man were partying, man were drinking, man were doing everything. Can you imagine them laughing at Noah? Look at that stupid man. He's putting all his money into that big boat on dry land. We've never even seen rain, this man talking about rain, much less a flood. Come on, man. And they remember 120 years, you know. So you can imagine that generation die and say, there's a man, his name is Noah. Go look at him, he's still building the boat. And that generation is dead. The next one comes on. Oh, my dad told me about that man, Noah. Oh, my grandfather told me about that man. But look who's laughing now. They say, paycheck to paycheck will be for you. But God is saying, more and more. God is saying, I will bless you. They're saying, sickness is for you. But God is saying, health, health, health. They're saying, you'll never come out to anything. But God is saying, I will make you the head and not the tail. All they're saying that they're coming up against you. But God will be your shield. God will be your buckler. They're saying, but God is saying, prophesy, prophesy, prophesy. So dry bones in action can only come to pass unless you have a relationship with God through Jesus Christ. So if you're going through your dry period right now, your period of hopelessness, whatever it is, stick to it. Stick to it, because God will deliver. Yes. You're going through a situation right now, but you don't know him as Lord and Savior. Come, and then you will realize the sinews, you will realize the flesh, you will realize the skin, you realize the breath of life. But all of this comes down to obedience to God through Jesus Christ. And that's what it's all about. In Jesus' name, amen.